Hi guys, Ben from Rock Country Outdoor Guys. Today we're going to unbox a Kni-co Trekker. It's a wood burning stove that you use in a hot tent or for outdoor camping. Conditions aren't optimal today. It's windy and I've got a lot of traffic, so hopefully you can hear me. But we're just going to unbox this, make sure everything's okay with it, and then I will do a test burn later. You do have to burn the chemicals, the manufacturing chemicals off of these things before you put them in a tent. I'll do that later. I don't have any wood ready. I wanted to see the interior size of this thing before I got the wood already. So we're just going to take it out and set it up, hopefully. So this is the smallest stove that Kni-co makes. They have like four or five other models that get increasingly larger. So fold your legs down. Ferguson's in the background running around, so it looks like we've got some installation and setup instructions, spark arrestor instructions, and stovepipe assembly instructions. So, look at those. Seems to be well packed. There's a lot of Alright, so there's the section of stovepipe. This is going to be the optional false bottom. You get that so that you don't wear out the bottom of your stove with heating and cooling. So this thing just fits in the bottom. That was extra. I'm going to recommend that you get that stuff. If you think you're going to want the optional stuff, get it when you buy the stove, because the extra shipping alone will kill you. Just to ship that little shelf was like $20-something if I hadn't got it with the rest of it. Camper. Cover the spark arrestor. Yeah, the spark arrestor. This comes in two parts and it's adjustable. So you just throw that in. Get it in back to the lid. And then you can adjust it out once you get it in there. Which is easier said than done. I'll do that later. Take a look at these instructions. Okay. here. I saw it. Okay, it's still quite dry. Some of the damper are losing the pin from the damper plate, slide the pin from the damper sleeve, pull through the damper plate, and then out the adjacent hole. So this is the... That's the damper. Nest firmly inside the previous pipe, crimped down into the diameter, continuing to add pipe corn to graduating size. Smallest pipe will be at the top. Progress through the top and measure the cup mesh end first. I'm probably going to be off camera here, but.
There you go. So I'm gonna bring in closer for a look at that. That's tilted a little bit. My stove could be tilted, the whole thing could be tilted, but there's the stack. I mean, that's probably a good 6 feet tall anyway. There's Ferguson. So you can add an optional shelf that attach right there to those two things. I should order at least one. Maybe I won't need them. That's a bigger surface than I thought it was gonna be to cook on and whatnot. And you could also get a water tank where you can put it in there to melt snow. You gotta be careful to make sure that they're balanced. And so here's the front. So you can dampen it here. And this opens up. If you can see the false bottom in there, you gotta spread that out across the bottom. It's in two sections. Alright, so guys, that was the Kni-co Trekker stove unboxing. Real quick, my first setup of it, which you can see I didn't really know what I was doing, but it wasn't that difficult. So what I'll do is, now I'm going to measure the inside of that box, and we'll cut some wood, and we'll save that for another video when we cut some wood up and burn those chemicals off. I am building a tarp tent out of a regular tarp from Home Depot, Lowe's, plastic tarp. Got that idea from Lonnie at Far North Bushcraft. I'll link to him and his tent instructions. He's got a real nice setup for a cheap hot tent made out of a plastic tarp. So I'll link to that. Also link to Kni-co so you can check the stoves out yourself. So Ferguson, get some wood ready for the fire. So thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you again next time.